How soon after giving birth does gestational diabetes go away? Well, let's talk about it. I'm Dr. Perkins, a board-certified OBGYN, and we talk about things like this and more right here on my channel. Welcome. In today's episode, we will talk about GDM, also known as gestational diabetes, how you get it, and how it goes away after giving birth. So, what is gestational diabetes? Know that any medical term that is preceded by gestational means that this is something that occurs in pregnancy. This is different from type 1 diabetes and very different from type 2 diabetes. Gestational diabetes is a diagnosis that happens after 20 weeks of pregnancy. As physicians and medical providers, the way that we identify gestational diabetes in a person is by checking the amount of glucose or sugar that remains in the blood vessels over time. Gestational diabetes is very similar to regular diabetes in the sense that there is not enough insulin being produced in the body sufficient enough to reduce the amount of sugars that are normally found in the blood. Let me dive a little bit further into what that means. Let's think of a meal, say lunch, and for lunch today you had a slice of pizza. Pizza has multiple different macronutrients, fats, protein, and carbohydrates. These are very, very important for helping your cells and your body and your organs function well. Fats are broken down and they're broken down by a different system. Protein is broken down by a different system. Carbohydrates are broken down as well, but carbohydrates need insulin to allow your cells and your organs to use it for energy. Glucose is actually the easiest type and form of energy that your body and your organs can use. Once your stomach breaks down this pizza into the carbs and the fats and the protein, these macronutrients are then shipped over to your liver, and your liver then has the responsibility for further breaking it down and helping it to be processed and be used by the rest of the body. Next step, these macronutrients are now found in your bloodstream. They circulate from your head to your fingers, to your heart, to your lungs, to your kidneys, to your toes. And essentially, as they are circulating in your blood, they're being packaged to each of your organs so they can get their amount of macronutrients that are needed for them to function. In terms of diabetes, for your cells and your organs to use the carbohydrates that you eat, insulin is needed to open up that door and to allow them to enter into the organs for usage. In some pregnant women, their ability to produce enough insulin reduces. And this reduction is simply due to changes in the placenta. Now, we're not at a place in medicine yet where we can say, hey, placenta, just start producing what you need to so that my carbohydrates may be used by my organs well. We're not able to do that. And so what happens in this female is that the amount of carbohydrates, which really breaks down to glucose or sugar in the body, builds up in the blood because none of the organs can use and take it from the blood. So the levels of sugar rises and rises and rises. And in pregnancy, most of that sugar gets dumped to the baby. And so the placenta, while it's creating this problem in your system, the placenta will not block additional sugar from going to your baby. And so your baby can be affected by having this increased amount of sugar being shipped into its body. This can lead to your baby being overweight, being larger than it needs to be for its gestational age. This can lead to your baby suffering and increasing the amount of insulin production in its body. This can become overwhelming and lead to stillbirths or your baby not surviving. So these states in pregnancy are very, very important and we take them very seriously. I hope you're enjoying our conversation so far, and if so, subscribe to this channel. I'd love to see you back. So we've talked about the effects of GDM on a baby. Now, what are the symptoms of a mother or someone carrying pregnancy? Well, none. Most people with GDM have no symptoms whatsoever. They have no idea that they're having imbalances having to do with their insulin internally. The way that we know that this is happening is by testing the glucose. And we do this in pregnancy by giving you a solution that is very strong in sugars. And we test how quickly you're able to remove the sugars from your blood. This is called a glucose challenge test. We typically recommend getting this test done somewhere between 24 and 28 weeks of pregnancy. In a normal person who is able to process sugars and carbohydrates well, those levels will be very low. In others who are either in the state of having GDM or may develop some level of glucose intolerance, the level when tested will be higher. If you happen to be diagnosed with GDM, I normally say it's completely okay. GDM is controllable. And it's controllable because if you make adjustments on the dietary side to be able to reduce the amount of carbohydrates, especially simple carbohydrates that you're taking in on a daily basis, the overall amount of sugar in your blood will be less. Some people may have difficulty or may need a little assistance in this. And with that, we're able to give medications to help to lower the sugar levels. We're able to give insulin to lower the sugar levels. That way you are protected and the baby's protected as well. Now, know that while we're talking about these terms, we're speaking of them in a very generic fashion. And I say that because we're all individual people, and sometimes we have risk factors that may warrant doing the test before 24 to 28 weeks. For instance, if you are obese, if you've had a previous pregnancy with GDM, if you have diabetes in your family, if you are Black or African American, these are risk factors that may warrant getting the test done earlier. Now, to answer your question, how quickly after giving birth does GDM go away? My answer is immediately. It's a beautiful thing. As soon as your baby exits your body and the placenta exits your body, you are no longer a diabetic pregnant woman. And so, literally, if you were on a diet before, that goes out the window. You become who you were before pregnancy. However, we do know that up to 5% of people with GDM may, in the long run, develop chronic diabetes. Because of that, we like to test you after each pregnancy with GDM, just to be sure that it's not still lurking in your system. And the way that we do that is by giving you another solution to drink and test how quickly glucose is removed from your blood levels. With that information, we will know exactly what your status is and whether or not you're in that 5%. I have a wonderful gift that I have for you today for listening throughout this entire video. This is my hormone balancing ebook called Hormones Don't Lie. Insulin is a hormone. And in understanding more and deeply about how our bodies function with hormones, we're able to live better lives, we're able to be better versions of ourselves, and create balance internally. Click the link below to get your free copy. I'm Dr. Perkins, a board-certified OBGYN, and it's been a pleasure, as always, talking with you about important parts of our bodies. Thank you for being here today, and we'll see you next time.